we are going to start. Today we are going to solve the next examples in the exercise or practice 1.1. So the question number 5 is, write two numbers which comes between. Write two numbers which comes between. This is the first example that we have write two numbers which comes between 84,192 and 84,195. Okay, so we have to write the numbers which comes between these two numbers. Okay, so let's find out those two numbers. For that, what we are going to do, you know, first we'll write this first number 84,192, and between these two numbers there are two numbers, right? So okay, these two dash I have written here, and the last number I'll write here, 84,195. Okay, so this is very easy. 84,192. After 84,192, we will get, see, just think about this 92. After 92, which number comes? 93, right? So the next number will be 84,193. Understood? Similarly, after 84,194, there is 84,195. So the between numbers of the numbers which comes between 84,192 and 84,195 are 84,193 and 84,194. Understood? Let's move towards the next question, question number 6. Write three numbers that comes in between these two numbers. Okay, so here in this question we have to write three numbers which comes between these two numbers. So see here which these two numbers are: 25,271 and 25,275. Let's solve similarly as we solved previous question. See, first we'll write here 25,271. As there are three numbers between these two, so let's write here three dash. Okay, then our last number 25,275. Fine. Now see, the first number is 25,271. Okay, so you know the numbers which comes after 71? 72. So the next number will be 25,272. Got it? Then after 72? Yes, 73. So 25,273. And after 73, 74. So 25,274. Understood? And after 25,274, we have 25,275. So these three numbers comes between these two numbers. Got it? So in these both the questions, first examples we have solved here. There is another one example B here, and here also example B that you have to solve as a homework. Got it? Let's move towards the next question. That is question number 7. The question is, counting by 7, write the 4 numerals from 19,385. So these are the questions of skip counting. As we have seen in previous lecture, the concept of skip counting we have learned, and these questions are based on that concept. Okay, so counting by 7, we have to write next 4 numerals after 19,385. Okay, so what we have to do here, as we have seen in our previous lecture, we have to add 7 in the given number. Okay, and when new number we will get, again in that number we have to add 7. So this way we have to do till we get 4 numerals. So let's do it. The given number is 19,385. In this number we are going to add 7, because we have to count 7 You know the counting or forward counting. This is nothing but forward counting as we have seen in the first standard. Forward counting. So here we have to just do forward counting by 7. That means we have to add 7 in the given number. So let's add. So 7 is for only 7, that is 7 ones. So that will be written at the ones place. Understood? Below 5. Now 5 plus 7, 12, right? So 2 will come down, 1 will be carried. 8 plus 1, 9. And remaining all digits same as there is no other digit to add. So we got 19,392. Now what to do to find next numeral? This new number right up. 19,392. Again, in this number, we have to add 7. Okay. So let's add 2 plus 7, 9. Correct. Then remaining all digits as it is. Now you have got this number 19,399. Write that up 19,399. And again add 7 in that. So 9 plus 7, 16. 6 will come down, 1 will be carried. 9 plus 1, 10. So 0 will come down, 1 will be carried. 3 plus 1, 4. And remaining all digits as it is. So we have got here third number 19,406. Okay. This number right up 19,406 plus 7. 6 plus 7, 13. Right? So 3 will come down, 1 will be carried. Now 0 plus 1, 1. And remaining all digits as it is, as there are no digits here down to adding them, so write them as it is. So here, this way, by counting 7, we have got next 4 numerals. After 19,385. So, which are those numerals? 19,392, 19,399, 19,406, and 19,430. Understood? Let's move towards the next question. That is question number 8. Counting by 300s. Counting by 300s. Write 4 numerals from 27,463. Same example, just here we added 7 because there was counting by 7. Here we have to count by 300. That means we have to add 300 in the given number. So the given number is 27,463. In this number we will add 300. Now see, 300 means 003. This is 300. This 0 will come at 1's place, this 0 will come at 10's place, and this 3 will come at 100's place. Let's add 3 plus 0, 3. 6 plus 0, 6. Correct? 4 plus 3. 4 plus 3? Yes, 7. And these two digits as it is. So we have got here next number, that is second number we have got 27,763. Let's write this number up. This number we write up 27,763, and again in this number, in this new number, we are going to add what we are going to add? Yes, 300. So again 003. 3 plus 0, 3 again. Yes, 6. Now see, 7 plus 3 we are getting 10. So 0 will come down and 1 will be carried. 7 plus is carried 1, 8 and here 2. Got it? Now this new number right now, 28,063 plus 300. Again 3 plus 0, 3, 6 plus 0, 6, 0 plus 3, 3, 8 and 2, 28,363. This is the third number we have got. This new number right now, 28,363 plus 300. So 3 plus 0, 3, 6 plus 0, 6, 3 plus 3, 6, 8 and 2. Understood? So this way when we, by counting, counting by 3 hundredths, when we found the 4 numerals from 27,463, we got these 4 numerals. 27,763, 28,063, 28,363 and 28,663. Understood? Let's move towards the question number 9. The question number 9 is counting by 5,000. See, counting by 5,000. Write 4 numerals from 6,32,847. So here we have to skip count by 5,000. So as we have done here, we have to add 5,000 in the given number. So let's do it. 6,32,847. Plus, you know 5,000, how to write 5,000? Yes. 5,000. Okay, so there are 4 digits. 0, 0, 0 and 1. This is 5,000. Let's add 5,000 in the given number. 7 plus 0, 7. 4 plus 0, 4. 8 plus 0, 8. 2 plus 5? Yes, 7. And remaining digits as it is. So we got 6,37,847. Write this number up. And again in this number add 5,000. Okay, so 7 plus 0, 7, 4 plus 0, 4, 8 plus 0, 8, 7 plus 5, see 7 plus 5, we are getting 12, right? So 2 will come down and 1 will be carried. 3 plus 1, here 4 and 6, so 6,42,847. Write this up. 6,42,847 plus 5,000. Okay. Now your 7 plus 0, 7. 4 plus 0, 4. 8 plus 0, 8. 2 plus 5, 7. Correct. Now your remaining all digits same. So 6,47,847. The next last one, fourth one number we will find. Write this new number up. 6,47,847 plus 5,000. See here. 7 plus 0, 7. 4 plus 0, 4, 8 plus 0, 8, 7 plus 5 again, 12, 4 plus carried 1, 5 and here 6, 6,52,847. So if you see here, when we added 5,000 in the given number, only this last 3 digits are as it is, 847, okay. Then the change will be there will be change in the thousands place digit, and whenever there will be carry, there will be change in the 10,000 place digit. Rest all digits are same, right? See, if you observe, you get that pattern. So these are the 4 numbers we have got after adding 5,000 or after counting by 5,000 from 6,32,847. So pause this video and write this in your notebook. Okay. After this, we will solve question number 10. Hello. Let's solve question number 10. It is HOTS question, higher order thinking question. So pay attention carefully and try to understand. Okay. See this question number 10. Give the number which is the successor. Give the number which is the successor of the predecessor. Successor of the predecessor of the smallest 6-digit number. So successor of predecessor of smallest 6-digit number, quite complicated, right? Don't worry, just pay attention carefully and try to understand. We have to find successor. But successor of what? You know, successor means next number. Right? So successor of the predecessor. Successor of predecessor. Predecessor means before number. Who's before number? Predecessor of the smallest 6-digit number. So here what we are going to do, how we are going to find answer C. First, we must know which is smallest 6-digit number. We must know, here it is not given. We should know how to find the smallest 6-digit number. There is one pattern, as we have learned previously. To find smallest 6-digit number, whenever we have to find smallest number of any digit, it may be 1 digit, 2 digit, 3 digit, 4 digit, 5 digit or 6 digit or 7, 8 or 9, whatever. How to find that? See, smallest 6-digit number. The smallest 6-digit number is, right, 1. We want 6 digit, right? So 1 we have taken here, so after 1 write 5 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we got 1 stay is 100, 1000, 10,000 and lakh, 1 lakh. So 1 lakh is the smallest 6 digit number. Got it? Now, come here in the question again. First we will find predecessor of the smallest 6 digit number. First we are going to find predecessor of smallest 6 digit number. And later, whenever we will get the predecessor, we have to find successor of that predecessor. Got it? So, predecessor of this number, smallest 6-digit number. This is S, right? So, to find predecessor, what we have to do? We need to subtract 1 from the number, that is 1 lakh minus 1. Now see, 0 minus 1 not possible, right? And here there are consecutive zeros are there. So what to do in this case? Cut last 0 right here, 10. Cut last next 0 right here, 9. And whenever you take number, cut that number and write its previous number. So previous number of 1 is 0. Okay. Now 10 minus 1, 9. And here there are no digits below the subtract, so write that all 9 as it is. So the predecessor of smallest 6-digit number is 99,999. That is predecessor of 1 that is 99,999. So we found the predecessor of smallest 6-digit number. Till this we have done. Then the main question is, give the number which is the successor. The successor of this predecessor. Again successor. Successor of the predecessor of smallest 6-digit number. See how step by step we have come to the end. See, first we found smallest 6-digit number, that is 1 lakh. Then we found predecessor of smallest 6-digit number, that is predecessor of 1 lakh. We got 99,999. Now we have to find successor of the predecessor of smallest 6-digit number. That is, this is the predecessor. So I am writing this predecessor here. And successor of this number is, successor means how we get successor? By adding 1. So again, if we add 1 here, so what we will get? Can you guess which number we will get? Without doing addition, can you guess which number we will get here? Yes, we will get, again we will get same number, 1 lakh, right? So 9 plus 1. 10. Again 9 plus 1, 10, 0 will come down, 1 will be carried. 9 plus 1, 10. 9 plus 1, 10, 0 will come down, 1 will be carried, and 9 plus 1, 10. So again we got same number, 1 lakh. Understood? So this is our answer. The successor of the predecessor of the smallest 6-digit number is 1 lakh. Got it? So here write this in your notebook, and here practice 1.1 is completed.